Okay, so now we know what it means to solve an equation. Let's get to the algebra and how we actually do that. How do we find that value of x that we need? Some preliminaries. First, the book talks about these properties of equality, even gives them name. There's a multiplication property of equality, an addition property of equality, subtraction, division. But rather than giving them a whole bunch of names, I just like to put it all underneath one hat, and I call it the golden rule. Right? So the golden rule of solving equations is basically this concept. Whatever you do to one side of an equation, you do the exact same thing to the other. So if I want to add a term to one side, I've got to add the same exact term to the other. If I want to multiply a factor to one side, I have to multiply the other side by the same factor. So I call that the golden rule, and that's basically what these things are saying. So if you multiply the same thing to both sides, you add the same thing to both sides, you subtract the same thing from both sides, or you divide the same thing from both sides. Later on, we can square both sides, we can square root both sides. So whatever math concept you're using, as long as you are doing the same thing to both sides, you're using the golden rule. You're in what I call a perfect balance. That's literally what algebra translates into, is balance. We have to keep ourselves balanced at all times. When you keep yourself balanced, you're building what are called equivalent equations. So the equation will look different because of the operation we did, but the solution will still be the same. So what I'd like to do is just demonstrate this golden rule with this equation. A lot of you are probably going to, let me preface this by saying some of you already kind of know the right things to do, but I'm just trying to demonstrate the golden rule that you can do whatever you want. As long as you do the same thing to both sides, you're going to build an equivalent equation. You're going to be okay. All right, so that's what I'm trying to demonstrate with these next examples. So you don't need to get your friends involved and say, oh, my professor's an idiot, he should just do this. All right, I will do that later, but I'm just trying to demonstrate the fact that you can do whatever you want. So that way you guys aren't so terrified when you're just solving an equation. Just try something. And as you try something, you'll get better. You'll start to get a feel for, well, this works better than that. All right, so for starters, we already know what the solution to this is. In the last video, we found that x equals 5 solves this, right? 3 times 5 is 15, plus 2 gives us 17. So we already know the solution. So I'm going to build an equivalent one. Let's go ahead and talk about addition, right? So I'm going to take both sides of this equation, and I'm going to add, let's say, 8 to both sides. All right, so again, the equation, I'm adding 8. So I'm using the golden rule of equality. Whatever I do to one side of the equation, I'm doing the exact same to the other. If we clean this up, this side becomes 3x plus 10 when we combine like terms, and this side becomes 25. So clearly this equation here is different than this equation here. All right, the language I would use is different. 3 times a number plus 2 equals 17 versus 3 times a number plus 10 equals 25. So the language is different, all right? However, they're equivalent equations, because if I tried letting x be 5, right, we end up getting a true statement. So 5 is still the solution of this new equation. So again, you can do whatever you want to both sides. As long as you do the same thing to both sides, you're okay. All right, let's go ahead and think of a multiplication, right? I've told you guys several times my favorite number is 2. So I'm going to basically take both sides of my equation, and I'm going to multiply both sides by 2. All right, so again, I'm in perfect balance. I'm using the golden rule. I'm doing whatever I want as long as I do it to both sides. So I'm multiplying this expression by 2. So to keep the balance, I'm multiplying that expression by 2. So what happens? Well, over here we do a distribution, right? That'll give us 6x plus 4, and 17 times 2 is 34. So this obviously is a very different equation from that one. It's a different equation from that one, and it's a different equation. So I've completely changed the equation. However, it's still equivalent, because if I go through and I substitute 5, right, 30 plus 4 equals 35, sorry about that, that should be a 34. 34 equals 34. All right, and so again, the idea of an equivalent equation, we basically have the same solution. I might look different, I might sound different, but the same number solves my equation. And so the golden rule, right, basically states you can do whatever you want as long as you do it to both sides. You're going to build an equation that is equivalent. It'll have the same solution. Now, the thing we want to do, though, is we want to use this golden rule not to make the equation look more complicated like I did, but to start making our equivalent equation look a little simpler. So let me kind of jump the gun here and show you some of your classmates are probably, why doesn't he just do this? All right, I'm just going to do that. All right, so a good move, right, a better move than all this stuff here is to actually take both sides and subtract 2. Again, I'm using the golden rule. I'm doing whatever I want. In this case, I'm subtracting 2 from both sides. All right, now why did I choose to subtract 2? Because this time when I combine like terms, right, 2 take away 2 is 0. So on this side, we're left with 3x. And then 17 take away 2 is 15. So again, I built an equivalent equation by doing the same thing to both sides, but my equation is actually simplified. It's a lot easier to look at. As a matter of fact, it's pretty easy to check that 5 is the solution, right? 3 times 5 is 15. But let's keep carrying on, because the idea is we got to get this x by itself. So what's my next balancing act that I'll play? Well, I'll take both sides, and I'll divide both sides by 3. Again, I'm using the golden rule, because I'm dividing both expressions on each side by the number 3. On this side, the 3's divide out, leaving us with x, and then 15 divided by 3 is 5. And lo and behold, there's the solution that we knew about from the very beginning. So here's obviously a more mathematical correct way to solve this equation. We're using the golden rule to kind of keep whittling away at it until we get the value that we can substitute in to make it true. But on this side, I'm just trying to demonstrate that you can do whatever you want. So as you guys are practicing, you know, don't fret too much about, oh, I got to do this or I got to do that. Yes, there are some better choices than others, but to get that understanding, maybe you play around with it. Try something. See what happens if I do this or see what happens if I do that. As long as you do the same thing to both sides, you're actually okay. You're doing good mathematics, right? Of course, there's good mathematics and then there's great mathematics. And in this case, right, this is the great mathematics, because not only do I play my balancing act, but at the end, I get my solution. So this is where we want to be, but you can do whatever you want to get there. All right? So obviously, our equations are going to get a lot tougher. All right? We'll keep using this golden rule, and we'll see you guys in the next video.